town. Shaken with conflict comes a ruthless blood sport where only the best stand a chance to survive. Do you have what it takes to become a legend?
Land here.
Apex. Okay, guys. It's Will here coming at you with a recorded commentary after this video. This was made during my stream, so... There, gotta mute my audio. Anyways, so yeah, this was done from a stream of mine, doing a series where I'm going to be painting up the main starter characters from the Apex board game. So starting off here, we have Bangalore, and to give some news here when this starts up, I'm watching the video as it's going, so I'm kind of talking, using that as a guide to line it up. So anyways, if I need to make black screens to pause it or something or slow things down, I will, but I'll try not to. But anyways, the Bangalore model I printed was actually a little bit larger than what it is. The models are going to be about Primaris Space Marine sized, a little bit taller than that. A 40 mil, basically, or if you played Star Wars Shatterpoint, they're going to be that sized. So we're going to skip up here. We've started the model by priming it with a Necro Cloak in the airbrush to give that grayish black pant lining there, as you can see with the picture down below. Sorry about the video quality, as I had to use my other backup cameras because I still have yet to get my good camera's dead battery, is what it's called, basically a battery you can plug into the wall. So starting off, we're pulling out basically here our starting colors, our base layers. We're doing the grays of the armor paneling, and we used ash gray, Necro Cloak, of course, for the base, Zelban Brown, it's from one of the Germer starter box there, the Filthy Cape, all these paints are going to be Army Painter with a splash of Citadel, using the Kowalski Wolf Hair number two brush, and a mix of other Army Painter brushes. This was actually a test also for a video, if you see my short, where I got the paintbrushes finally in after waiting a few years. So with Army Painter there, as you can see, I did a little thing where I slowly pulled the lid open. Army Painter paints, depending on like if it's a metallic or a thicker paint, they have an issue with pressure in their nozzle, where as soon as you open them, they'll just sploosh all over. So I opened it over the ledge to basically make sure it wouldn't explode on me. Sometimes it'll be watery and you have to let some out, shake it up a bit, just like a ketchup bottle, and then it'll be fine. I have bad arms, so I have to use a paint shaker. So what I do every month, or if it's summer when it's really hot out, like we had that heat waves a few last year, I was shaking them every 3 weeks. I just use my paint shaker on the really thick ones, and on the watery ones I just shake in my hand. But we're just going to go here and paint, and we'll let my stream self talk this way. Yeah. So here I am, I'm back, looking at this. As you can see, the gray of the, I believe this is the pants here, as you're saying. Let this play. Basically saying that's where you want your paint to be on these, especially these natural hair brushes. You don't want the paint to ever go past that point, because if it goes further down the bristles, it will mess up the glue inside and spread it. So here we're painting the knee pads and the shoulder pads, the outer like lower part, not the raised edge, with our darker gray, which I believe is the ash gray. So we're going to let myself continue that. We're going to paint that, and when we come back, we'll talk about the next color. So here, you guys, we're going to be coming up here. You're going to see a part where there's a spot where I skipped by accident, but you're going to see what it looks like here with the boots and the shoulder pads and all the gray parts painted with the different colors. And then we're going to be moving on to the brown of the clothing. So the outer padded cloth of her uniform. As you can see on the left side there under the cat cam, that is the colors that we've used. If you The live stream of this was on my Twitch. If you want to see my full painting videos, next Saturday we're going to be painting up Wraith. So if you guys want to make sure that you're there for that, use the links on my YouTube channel banner to go to my Twitch channel, and we'll be streaming again on there to paint the Wraith, which is going to be more actually to scale to what the actual models are going to be. Here we're using now the Zeltban camo brown mixed in with a bit of Steel Legion drab just to refill the pot. It's a little bit watery, but that's just because that's how army painter comes out. So I had to do multiple layers on this, so we'll come back once I'm done that and we'll continue our chats on the stream. So enjoy the painting. So here now, as you can see, I may have just said it, we're now using the Kanak stone, the airbrush sand color from Citadel to paint the ledges. If I was to come back and redo this, actually it works pretty well. It's basically what I do, looking at it now through the camera instead of in person. In person, I would have flipped the colors around. But on camera here, how it looks now, it looks how it would in the picture. Yeah, so I did accidentally cut this part out. So what happened was we painted the yellow bands, as you can see on her armor here, on her picture there, that holds the straps of her grenades, her smoke grenades. I painted that yellow with a Phoenix Flame from Army Painter. And now we are moving on to the skin tone using Catachan skin to paint the base textures. On her head, she has cuts into the side of the hair to give that brick sort of lined look on the side. I don't know what you'd exactly call it, I forget. But it made an interesting style. And I just decided to cover up parts that didn't fully come out of the printer. Though the eyes and whoever made this model did a fantastic job. And you could just print it how it is when it comes in. But if you want it to be to scale to the board game when it comes out, I'd say set it to about the height default without rotating it. The height should be about, I have this model currently at 43 millimeters is the height of the y-axis, right? That's the height one, I believe. Whatever the height is. It's about 43 millimeters. So I'd say probably shrinking it to about 36 and trying it there should help. We're coming in with the grays here to top up the whites, parts that should be white. Basically where the sun is hitting, how we're doing it is the sun is coming from her right side down above her. So from the shoulder where that little white square is looking down. So we're basically just topping up all the armor bits and gray of the armor and cloth with that color. Here we go. This is the base painting done. As you can see, it looks kind of Fisher-Pricey and toy-like. That's fine. The eyes look off, but in person, the white was actually blended into the brown. Here we go. We're now starting with the base. My favorite part of models. This one was actually really well done. It's a free base I found on Thingiverse. You can scale it. They have multiple different sizes with different textures and things on it. Taking the Army Painter Monster Brush or base brush, we're just going around and painting the trees and the ground using Castellan Green for the base coat. The brush I use is pretty nice. It is a natural hair brush, but it is durable. It is meant to take a beating as long as you know you follow the same instructions. Now we're going to move on to Mournfang Brown here for the dirt. We found a picture online where I think it's one of the gorges or whatever, the first map, where there's bright sand-like dirt. So we start dark, and with that almost zenithal-esque-like necromantic cloak spray we did, it gives it already a pre... And you can kind of see that effect here on that base. Dry brushing... As you may see it as we get to this point, I've dry brushed with the Zeltone brown, and then went in with some other orangey colors to to, you know, change up the fauna. And then here, as we're waiting for it to dry, so we can dry brush and do our washes, because the base is glued to a piece of plastic to hold it above the painting handle's grips, because this is the Citadel ones from back in the day, I thought it was a good time to paint the first layer of the base ring. Alright, here we go. We're dry brushing the base. And why we do this before the washes is, if you, especially if you hit it with a lot of bright white color or whatever matching color, like Dawnstone and stuff, when you hit it with that wash, it's going to blend in almost like a contrast or a speed paint. And it's going to look pretty, it's going to dull it down enough and things like that. And then you can come back and re-dry brush if you want to re-affect it, but it'll do pretty well. You can see that we're now applying the white glue. So we're going to add a mix of static grasses around the plants just to show growth. We're using a dark, almost like pool table felt. I think that's how they used to make it back in the day too, because this is old Citadel stuff I'm using. That mixed in with a almost dead earth, dead grass, Woodland Scenics ripoff brand. Actually really nice, comes from Europe. Was about like $20-$30, and unless you're doing big boards, which it's designed for. And here you go. This is what it looks like when it's done. If you have any white glue showing, it'll disappear after it dries. But you want to make sure it's fully dried before it, you know, you seal it. So here we go. We got the washes. We're using a Recline Flesh Shade, Agrax Earth Shade, and a non-oil in the containers. The non-oil and the Agrax has been mixed with Army Painter Strong Tone and Dark Tone. You know, going to their appropriate matching colors from Citadel. As you can see, Gigi is awake and she is looking around. And so yeah, we're just going to apply, we're applying the non-oil all over the dark parts. So the grays, the whites, the necro cloak, the gun, her hair, we're going to apply it to there. So now we're going to apply, after this, we're going to apply the Agrax to the cloth, the clothing, and to the base. And then after that, we're going to apply the Recland to the face and to the ground in certain areas to give it a shade. Here you go, this is the base and all the model dried after the basing. And we're gonna come back in with the just dry brush there, the stone skull, it's skull something, it's one of the old dry brushes. And we're just gonna hit this all over the base, especially on the parts where there's rock and stone in it. And then hit all over the model and on trees and stuff. After that's set, we're gonna come in here. I know it's kind of blurry, the camera is having issues trying to focus because the light is bouncing off my CD palette, there you go. But we're going in and we're hitting all the raised areas and where there's scratches and dings on the armor, where the paint could have like still be fresh there. And of course, you know, going off that light source to give the armor a more whitish color. And when it dries, all these Army Painter stuff, especially if you just do one layer with the washes and Citadel stuff and water down how I do it, I find it actually dries dimmer than what it is and actually kind of naturally blends in. I don't know if I'm just naturally doing a sort of like wet blend, but I find most of my colors just naturally dry dimmer and they blend in. So here we are going on to, so here we are, we're coming in with the gray, I'll find the gray, but we're coming in with the, basically, I think it's Dawnstone, we're coming in with Dawnstone, and we're hitting now the darker grays, so the underclothing, the pants, and the darker recesses of the boots, and hitting them with that. Next, we're coming in with the skin paints, and this part, I hate the most. Faces, and especially eyes, do not go hand in hand. I have shaky hand problems, so I can't paint at all. So, using this death claw brown, we're going to use it on the skin and on the clothing. Yeah, here we are. We're now actually applying the paint, at least from the part I'm seeing. And yeah, we're, again, just like the boots and the clothes, we're hitting that highlighted area. At this point, I can maybe probably give some talk about what I'm, why I'm really excited into the game. Because after this part, we're going to be doing the face, and that's going to cut a bit. But the Apex board game is basically being released by Glass Cannon, the guys who did the board game for Frostpunk. They have some models for free in Model Building Simulator, which that game is incredible. And I hope more companies does stuff with them. As you saw the light flashing there, I was trying to use a lamp to see better but not mess up the camera, and the battery's just straight up died in it. So we're back to this. As I stumble with this face, it's made by Glass Cannon. It's a 40mm skirmish style game, kind of like Shatterpoint or Battletech of how the board works. And instead of using dice, it uses a card-based flip modifier thing. Using a track of numbers, pre-selected numbers, that will go down or up depending on factors based off cards and abilities and weapons. If you've ever played Gloomhaven or Slay the Spire or Murata or whatever the anime version of Gloomhaven's called, you'll know how this combat works. It looks beautiful, the game looks fun, it's free to play on Tabletop Simulator. It's a lot of fun, I've kickstarted it, and when it comes out we will definitely do a review with it. And it'll be my big channel, project for that year. This year I'm kind of just relaxing, trying to get stuff done. But as you can see here, the base looks fantastic. I love this base. I think it was my all-time favorite. This video is not sponsored because I'm not worth sponsoring. I know that. But so here we go. We're about to see the final project. This is the final photo. I know the eyes look funky in the video. But in person, the eyes and the white and all that stuff blends really well. In fact, as you can see, we added some wet mud effects under her feet to kind of get that riverbed look. Made the boots dirty to look like she's been running around the dirt there. But besides that, I think this was a really nice model I liked building. But with that, guys, thank you for watching this video. I hope you enjoy. Please check out the stuff on my Twitter. And hope you guys have a good night. Click the video. Click it. Click the video. You know you want to. Click it.